you don't say.
Hi guys, it's Dill, and I'm here today to show you guys how I did this coral gold peach look. It's something that I wear a lot, especially when I'm on vacation. I'm not on vacation right now, but I might as well do my makeup and look like I'm going somewhere like tropical, even though it's raining outside. And for LA, that's really weird because it doesn't rain here. In the past week, it's been raining. So I really need LA to get back to normal because a girl is suffering from seasonal affective disorder. That's what your girl is suffering from right now. It's a real condition. I mean, somewhat real. Hope you guys enjoy these videos. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe and hit post notifications because I have a lot of videos coming out soon, a lot of things to share, and a bunch of trips planned. Weddings, like the wedding of the century, is happening this summer, and I plan on recording a bunch of looks for it, and I plan on like vlogging. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and yeah. So the first thing we're gonna do is start off by doing our eyeshadow. That's just what I like to do. So I'm just gonna take some concealer and put it on my eyelid to like, as a base. Take the Huda Beauty powder in Banana Bread, and I'm just gonna set my entire eyelid. I'm gonna take the Huda Beauty Warm Brown Obsessions palette, and the first color I'm gonna take is this one that's at the bottom. It's kind of like a corally orange, and I'm just gonna place that like all over, kind of like the eyelid, all over the eyelid. Okay, then I'm gonna take like a flat shader brush, and I'm going to dip back in to that same coral color and just kind of concentrate it on the eyelid, make sure that it's like packed on there. Okay, so once we're content with how much eyeshadow is packed onto there, I'm going to take, go into the orange and kind of mix it with this like terracotta color at the bottom. And I'm just gonna put this in the crease to intensify it up a little bit. Okay, once I have a nice like wash all over the eyelid, I'm going to add some shimmer to it because I want to. So basically I'm just gonna take that gold that's in that palette and just pat some on the lid. We're gonna do some eyeliner. So I take the Tarte liner and I take the felt tip side and I'm just gonna do like a regular winged liner. Okay, now I can start doing face makeup so that I don't look like I'm dying, because right now I'm like, my dark circles are next level. Oh, prime my face. So I take the Tatcha, the Silk Canvas primer, and I'm just gonna put this all over my face. I just use my fingers. Don't find the need to be extra and use like a brush. Cover FX color correcting little stick in orange, and I'm gonna color correct my under eyes. And I put some of this like near my mouth area because I don't want to look ashy. So now I'm gonna take my foundation. So I use the Huda Beauty Faux Filter Foundation in the shade 310G, which is Amoretti. And I'm just gonna put this all over my face. And I usually like to do like a heavy full glam. So if I'm using this foundation, like I'm gonna put a lot of it on. And I feel like at first it looks kind of weird, and then once it oxidizes, it's like the right shade, so. I'm just gonna take my beauty blender. I find that this works the best. Then I'm gonna take concealer. So I use the Tarte Shape Tape in the shade medium. And then I add a little bit of light medium honey. I'm gonna take my Becca Soft Light Blurring Powder in the shade Golden Hour, and I'm gonna place this like all over my under eyes. And I'm gonna take the Huda Beauty powder I was using earlier, and I'm gonna place this powder like underneath the cheekbone area. Now I'm going to do my favorite part, which is contouring. So I take my Shade and Light palette, and I use the Kat Von D brush too. And I'm gonna take the darkest shade first and start contouring my face. I love contour, so if you don't like contour, probably not gonna like the way I do this, but I like my cheekbones to look snatched. And I'm just gonna take the lighter powders and mix them all up and kind of place them in the areas I'm not putting the dark contour. Mom would like FaceTime. What the f? Hello? I know, and I picked up. I picked up and then it ended. I'm gonna take the Juvia's Place blush in Serafina and put this all on my cheeks. I'm move on to doing the under eye area. Let me put some shadow there. So I'm just gonna take a tinier brush and the same palette I was using, and I'm going to take the orange shade. Okay, and then take the darker color that I was using and put that in the outside third. And then take the shimmery gold. I'm actually gonna place that in the inner third. Now I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows. This takes me like 2 seconds because my eyebrows, as you can tell, are naturally kind of bushy. So I'm just gonna take the Anastasia Brow Dip Brow Pomade in Ebony and I'm just gonna fill in like the fronts a little bit. Now I'm just gonna take the Makeup Forever Brow Seal and just seal my brow hairs into place. Once I've done that, I'm going to highlight my face now. So I'm gonna take the Anastasia Ambrezy highlight and I use this little ratchet brush, my good old ratchet little brush. I'm gonna move on to mascara and things like that because that makes the biggest impact on my face, I feel like, is eyelashes. Without them, I am nothing. I'm gonna take the Tarte Lights, Camera, Splashes mascara and just do like one coat on my eyelashes. I wanna put my eyelashes on, so I'm gonna use my all-time favorite Lily Lashes in Mykonos, and I legit like only wear these lashes. Like the amount of times I've purchased them is ridiculous, but I love them. I'm gonna do this off camera because it takes too much time. So, or I think I have my eyelashes on. Because honestly, like, I feel like the real test is 30 minutes after you put your eyelashes on. If they're still on, then you're good. But now I'm going to do my under eye mascara. Once you're content with how much mascara you have on your lower lash line, I'm just gonna take a powder or my brush and brush away the powder. Okay. And then now I'm gonna take some eyeshadow to put in the inner corner of my eyes and under my brow bone because I forgot to do that. So I'm just gonna take the Norvina palette and I'm gonna use the shade called Base. And then I'm gonna take the shade Dreamer and apply that in the inner corners of the eye. So now I'm gonna do my lips because I think that's the only thing I have left. So I'm gonna take my Huda Beauty lip pencil and Trendsetter. I'm just gonna line my lips real quick. Oh shit, I need to eat lunch. What time is it? 3:20. I should post make some food. Okay, so once I've like quickly like shittily lined my lips, I'm gonna take the color Miami by Kylie Cosmetics and put this all over my lips. I love this color. I was wearing clothes, wearing tube top. This tube top is actually like my mom's from like the 90s. So this is the final look that I came up with. and Valentine's Day is in a few days, and honestly, I feel like this look you could wear for Valentine's dinner. I'm just wearing like a nice, like off-the-shoulder white dress with it.
You're